Hi, I'm Amy, and this is Ricky and her big brother Eli, who once again are enjoying their Nylabones, and welcome to week 14 of Grown Up Guide Pup. This should be a very exciting episode for you guys. We're going to talk about traveling with your guide dog pup. We took Ricky on a trip down to Southern California for the very first time, so we hit up a lot of places while we were down there. We took walks around Hollywood Boulevard and got to see a lot of stars on the Walk of Fame. We ended up running into Jack Sparrow and Marilyn Monroe and even Darth Vader. Go figure. You never know who you're going to see in Hollywood. We visited the Chinese Theater where we walked around, checked out all the hand footprints of the stars, and Ricky made some fans of her own. There was a little boy who wanted to pet her, and she did very well with that. She enjoyed the attention. Some important things to remember when traveling with a guide dog puppy is to bring comfort items, her favorite toys, a blanket of hers that she likes to lay on, her food bowls, plenty of food, anything that she would need for the entire trip to keep her happy and busy. So as we've mentioned in the past, Ricky is the 10th puppy that we have raised, and she's the third dog that we've actually traveled with and proved to be an amazing puppy. She's also the youngest puppy that we've traveled with. We traveled with Macklin, who you guys met in week 8, and we did take him to Disneyland, and I also took him to Las Vegas. And another dog that we traveled with who you have not met is our little Prudy, who was puppy number 8, and I did a similar trip with her, but she was about 14 months old, and we went down to LA also with her and proved to be a pretty amazing puppy. Ricky did fantastic. She didn't have a single potty accident. She went to the bathroom basically where I have picked out for her and went every time. We had some problems with Prudy and Macklin, in fact, where they didn't like where I picked for them to go to the bathroom, and it was kind of difficult to get them to go because it wasn't the normal routine and it wasn't the normal place. Ricky turned out to be fantastic at this. She'd hold it for as long as she could and give me little signals that she had to go, and I would find an appropriate place for her to go to the bathroom, and she went. No accidents, no problems. It was wonderful traveling with her. We even went over to City Walk, where we've discovered some fountains that came up from the ground. Ricky was intrigued by these, and we took this opportunity. It was warm out, and she had been working for a while, to let her have a little bit of fun and cool off in the fountains. Little did we know that she'd actually try biting at the water as they popped up from the ground. It was very cute, quite funny, and she kind of enjoyed herself. So it was a nice break for her from working. She definitely showed us that she is a water dog at heart, and she's proved to be a combination of both being a golden retriever and a Labrador, both breeds that love water. We finished up our time down in the Hollywood area with catching the Tonight Show and even going to the Grove, where many famous people shop. That's all the time we have for now, so join me next week for week 15 when we continue to show you footage from our Southern California trip. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.